Finding Zuzo.
Wait, what? Where'd I go?
There you are. What are you doing up here? Just thinking about the first time my parents brought me to Nueva Vista when I was just a little girl. You see that lighthouse? My father had it built. Ooh, really? Okay, you're fidgeting with your necklace. What's bugging you?
Well, actually, it's about the lighthouse. It's
so beautiful.
Too short.
Too short? It's one of the tallest buildings in the city.
But it's not tall enough. My dad and I have been working with the local harbor master. The port's so busy that they have to signal ships to wait for dock space. But the lighthouse is too short to be seen by ships way out in the ocean.
Okay, then let's make it taller.
We already looked into that. The foundation won't support it.
So, what exactly are you saying?
We need to tear it down and build a new one.
Tear it down? Tear down the lighthouse my father built? The lighthouse that is a symbol of Avaloran pride? That lighthouse?
I know it means a lot to you, but this is the best solution.
The best solution is destroying a piece of Avalor's history?
If it helps Avalor's future, yes.
I think I know what's best for my kingdom. Thank you.
Well, it's not entirely up to you, Elena. A decision this big is made by the Grand Council.
Oh, fine. Go to the Council and let them tell you what a terrible idea it is.
They won't, because it's a great idea.
We'll see.
I guess we will.
Hey.
Oh. Hey.
I shouldn't have...
You first.
I'm sorry I was so hard-headed.
I've got you beat there.
You know, if we put our hard heads together, I'm sure we can figure this out.
I am too.
Okay, we need a taller lighthouse, right?
Right, but without tearing the old one down.
So, what if we move the old lighthouse to higher ground?
You mean dismantle it?
And rebuild it on one of those rocks.
Then it would be visible from way out in the ocean. Problem solved. Should I assemble the rest of the Grand Council so you can tell them your great idea?
Let's tell them together.
I would like to apologize to you, Sophia. You see, I never had a friend before Roma, so I never knew how it would feel when they were in trouble. Now I'm going to help Miss Nettle with her wake-upsie daisies. Oh, it made me feel so good to help him.
But what about the color?
Oh, look! Miss Nettle made these for me.
Miss Nettle, have you two become friends?
Don't make a big deal out of it. But yes, I suppose we are.
Ivy, I think the animals made something for you. To say thanks.
It's beautiful. All I wanted was a kingdom of my own, but I guess I had one all along.
Even better, you have friends. Maybe that's why the amulet sent me, to help you see that. Look, time to go, Whatnot.
Thank you, Sophia.
Good luck, again.
So long, princess.
Bye, everyone.
Just the news. Hi, I'm Nadia Shamak, and this is Side by Side. Today, I'm joined by Alia Cesaire, who created the Lady Blog. Together, we'll be looking back over Cat Noir and Ladybug's greatest feats.
Your ratings are really high, Nadia.
Great job. You've earned this primetime show.
Hello, Nadia. Hey, fam. So, first of all, I gotta set the record straight. Cat Noir and Ladybug are not a couple. Well, not yet, at least. Sorry to break the news.
Hey, look! That's you with my mommy!
That's right, small fry.
Well done! Now everyone's gonna know about the Lady Blog.
You want an autograph?
Of course!
Help me first!